First special guest is no other than India's biggest YouTube sensation, who goes by the name of BBQ Vines, and he's in the studio with me right now. I heard this somewhere. You made 75 videos in 1 year.
Yeah.
That's a lot in 1 year, is it not?
I know, but I compensated it in the next year by making just 15.
Oh, right. Okay. You're a professional at this now.
So it takes me around 2 weeks to write.
Okay.
And shoot,
so you write
and
your own material.
Yeah. Right from the writing part to the shoot to the edit and the marketing.
So you're your own director, your own producer. Yeah. Everything is just you.
Yeah.
I like it. You're very original. Now, you're very popular out here with the youth.
Yeah.
What do you think it is that connects you and the youth together? Why is it so relative to them?
Because, see, I talk about friends. I talk about the middle class families. Mm-hmm. And that's the thing which most people relate to. So we all go through the same problems. Like, the mom is always nagging. The dad is always defending.
We can all agree.
The dad is always defending. And you have those witty, clever, nonsensical friends. So that's what the youth in India relates to.
And it's good to keep that going, isn't it?
Yeah.
Because that's what they want to see.
Yeah, and also the content is in Hindi. So
Even better.
Yeah.
So everyone, it brings it more to life.
So before YouTube, I used to perform in a restaurant. And
okay.
I played there for 2 years. Mm-hmm. I used to perform with my guitar and a keyboard. And I performed there for 2 years. From Monday to Sunday, every day, from 8 to 12 p.m. And without any holiday, for 2 years straight. From then, I realized that I need to write my own stuff. Because everyone sings the cover songs. Mm-hmm. You need to be original. So to make a mark. Somewhere.
So this is the thing. You have a huge passion for singing as well.
Yeah,
when did this begin? From a young age? Have you always enjoyed that?
I started my classical singing training when I was in fourth grade. And then I left it for no reason. Because I wanted to be an astronaut. Then I wanted to be a cricketer. Then I wanted to be a painter.
I wanted to do
so many things. But then later I realized that music is the thing which I actually want to pursue.
Well, you need to tell me when your mum first heard your YouTube stuff.
So I really wanted to tell her that I'm doing this kind of a stuff on YouTube. So, but someone in her office asked her to watch my videos because they were watching my videos in the canteen area.
Okay.
And that too without headphones.
So she's at work.
Yeah, she's at
work. No headphones.
Yeah, no headphones, nothing.
Somebody's asked her to listen to your stuff.
Yeah, and the content is completely 18 plus.
Mm.
And so
18 plus, everyone, bear this in mind.
Yeah.
Right,
so
okay, no headphones.
So you need to have headphones. But my mom saw that video and she called me up. And she was like, is that you? And I'm like, yeah.
Oh, if that was me, I would have said, no, that's not me.
I had to accept because she said the room looks like the one on the terrace. So like, yeah, it's that room. Okay, mm-hmm. I'm coming home. And she hung up on me. Later that night, she came home and then we were sitting. Now, even my dad got to know that I'm doing this stuff.
Okay, so she's already told your dad now.
Yeah.
This gets even more scary now, doesn't it?
Yeah, I thought it was scary and I was really scared. We were eating food. My dad asks me to put on the video on TV.
Okay.
I want to watch. And I was really scared.
What did you do? Did you say okay?
Yeah, I had to do it. He loved it.
Oh.
Yeah.
He
was like,
great.
He was like, I'll get you some more ideas so that you can put in. And my mom was like, why are you supporting him? He's like, he's not killing anyone. He's making people smile. Look at the views. Look at the views. People are watching him. People are following him.
Your dad's your number one fan.
Yeah. And now even my mom has joined the party.
So she supports you now.
Yeah, she supports.
See, I was going to touch upon this. Now, a lot of Asian parents from our culture, it's hard for them sometimes to kind of accept a career that's not really normal to them, you know?
I know, but it's fair
but
on their part.
But you're breaking barriers. Yeah,
I
understand.
Their part. If I were in their shoes, I would have done the same.
Yeah.
But they're pretty cool. And so this is what happened. I told them after I passed out from my school, I told them that I've listened to you for 12 years straight now. Please give me 2 more years.
And
let me do something.
Oh.
If I don't make it, I'll do whatever you say. And that's what happened.
And they're proud of you now.
They're really proud of
you. They're very proud of you now. Now, you are now one of India's biggest YouTubers, right? Now, you have to tell me how that feels. What is it like to have a label like that?
It's really stressful.
Is it?
Yeah,
I can imagine.
It is. Because when you're about to release a video, so it's almost 5 million people were waiting to actually see what you're going to do.
People.
Yeah, and
that's
it's really
a lot
scary. It's really scary. I try not to think about it and stress myself even more, but it happens.
So do you feel like there's constant pressure all the time? Because you're always watching how many followers you've got, how many hits you're going to get.
Yeah.
You know, but that's always in your mind, isn't it?
Yeah, but I think I've crossed the phase. I passed that phase when I check the views and I check the subscriber count. So it's like, I know now people are there to watch my content. Now
and
I just need to focus. I need to focus on what I'm going to give them.
Okay. And we have to ask, how many subscribers are you standing at right now?
Almost 5.6 million.
Almost 5.6 million.
Yeah.
So we've got to know you a little bit better now.
Yeah.
But we now need the listeners to hear exactly your what else you can do, your other skill on the side, which is singing. Yeah. Now, you have written this song that you're about to perform. Tell us a little bit about this.
So it's a love song and I'm kind of a romantic guy.
Oh, are you?
Yeah. Okay. So I love to write such songs.
So you've written a bit of a lovey-dovey tune.
Yeah, yeah. But it's not a typical lovey-dovey song.
Okay.
It's about two friends fall in love. That's it.
Now, before you get into this, I have got a couple of amazing facts right in front of me. Now, this, across all music genres, in under 2 hours, reached number one on iTunes. Is that right?
Woo. Yeah.
How did that make you feel when you saw that?
See, it's hard to believe. Such things can happen.
Mm-hmm.
Like, independent music is India is not of that level which it can match the level of Bollywood. But still, it feels really good.
It also beat tracks like, you know, Swag Se Swagat from the film Tiger Zinda Hai. It's also trending right now, number one in India, which is amazing. But before I go on and on and on about that, we really need to hear this voice. So in your own time, take it away.
So the song's called Sang Hoon Tere. किस्मत से पहले ना किस्मत से ज्यादा मिला है हर किसी को जिंदगी में बातों ही बातों में तेरा यूं मुस्कुराना संग हूं तेरे संग हूं तेरे तू मेरा आशियाना तू मेरा है ठिकाना संग हूं तेरे